Hello, thank you for joining us for today's webinar on how to choose the right relief valve. We're glad that you're with us today. My name is Anil Krasian, and
my name is Dan Fernandez.
And before we jump right into the topic today, just a couple of brief housekeeping rules. When you joined the webinar today, your microphones were automatically muted, and we're going to ask that you remain muted throughout the entire presentation today. That is actually so that we can all enjoy the best audio quality possible. Also want to let you know that today's webinar is going to last approximately 30 minutes, and there will be ample time to ask questions and have those answered at the end of that webinar. On the topic of questions, I want to tell you how that process works. If you are looking at your GoToWebinar control panel on the right-hand side of your screen, all the way at the bottom of that tab, you'll actually see a chat feature. And we'll just let you know that you can chat in questions at any time during our presentation today, and we'll go ahead and we'll answer those questions as soon as we can. Also want to let you know that there are quite a few people on the webinar today, and so if you've joined us and you've asked a question and we haven't quite gotten to your answer by the time we're done today, don't worry. We are collecting all of your email addresses as well as any questions that you would send in to us, and you will get a response from Sun Hydraulics with an answer to your question before we're done. So, today's topic, how to choose the right relief valve. We're going to go ahead and make a recording of today's webinar as well. And if you've joined us today, we're going to go ahead and send you a link to the video as soon as it is available. But let's go ahead and jump right into the topic today. Dan, we're talking about relief valves today. And maybe we should start with a bit of an overview. What does a relief valve do? And tell me all about them.
Absolutely. A pressure relief valve is a critical part of every hydraulic system. You find them in almost all hydraulic systems because they set the maximum pressure in your hydraulic system or regulate the maximum pressure in a system. So every component in a hydraulic system has some pressure rating or maximum recommended working pressure. That includes your hoses, your actuators, cylinders, motors, your pump. So a relief valve's job is to make sure that that pressure is not exceeded, or you regulate pressure below those maximum working pressures of everything else in your system.
Okay. So from what you're talking about, it sounds to me like a relief valve is really a pretty major component for safety.
Absolutely. So if your working pressure is above the maximum rated pressure of your components, you could see failures, actuators falling. Obviously, that could be very dangerous.
Okay. Well, we've got a circuit schematic on the screen. Is it safe to say that every circuit should have a relief valve?
Yeah. For example, you see this simple hydraulic circuit. There's a relief valve right off the outlet of the pump on the left side. That makes sure that the hoses, the directional valve, the cylinder, once it reaches full extension, you're going to see relief pressure as long as that fixed displacement pump keeps providing flow. You're going to see full relief pressure there to make sure that the pressure does not exceed that setting. Even on a pressure compensated pump that has variable displacement and you see the pump de-stroke at a certain pressure, it's still wise to have an inexpensive relief valve in the system just in case the compensator fails and you can protect that investment. So it's certainly a major component that should be in every hydraulic system.
Okay. So I guess the question becomes then, we have a lot of different relief valves. Sun manufactures quite a few different relief valves. There's a ton of them on the market. But I guess really the whole point of today's webinar is to try and get to how it is that we choose the right relief valve for our system. Mm-hmm. How do you think we should go about that?
Well, I think the best place to start is to differentiate the difference between pilot-operated and direct-acting relief valves, which is really a design characteristic, but that design ends up giving you certain performance characteristics that might be needed.
Okay. So why don't we start this way? If you've joined us for the webinar today, we're going to ask for a little bit of participation from you. In just one moment, you're going to see a live survey that's going to pop up on your screen. And we just want you to take a moment to grab your mouse and click on one button. We're just going to ask you for one answer to one simple question. And that's going to help us on our end just kind of figure out how we're going to handle the rest of the webinar today. Mm-hmm. So the question that you're going to see on your screen in just one moment is going to read this way. It's going to say, are you comfortable with your understanding of the difference between direct-acting and pilot-operated relief valves? Again, it says, are you comfortable with your understanding of the difference between direct-acting and pilot-operated relief valves? And what's going to happen is as you answer that question, we're going to go ahead and compile all that data, and we'll actually show you the results in a percentage standpoint in just a moment. And I anticipate this. I anticipate that there's going to be a percentage of you that have joined us today that are very comfortable with the differences between direct-acting and pilot-operated. And I'm also anticipating that there's going to be a pretty large percentage that is not really comfortable with that difference. Mm-hmm. So we'll show that in just one moment, but I think it's a valid question because it helps us to really show the differences from a physical standpoint of our valves and then how that changes the operational performance of the valves.
Sure. And, you know, here at Sun, we're very focused on the design parameters of cartridge valves. That's our daily business. But, you know, not everybody knows the difference between direct acting and pilot operated, and relating that to how it will perform in your system is going to be very helpful.
Okay. So we'll go ahead and throw some results up on the screen here in just one moment. It looks like we're still compiling that information. Should be available in just the next moment. Okay. There we are. So about 76% of you that have joined us today are exceptionally comfortable with the difference between pilot operated and direct acting, and about a quarter of you are not the most comfortable. So we're going to take a moment to go ahead and discuss those differences. And what we're going to do is, I guess we should probably start by, what do you think, visiting the website?
Yeah, let's look at direct acting valves.
Okay.
And just a note, this is an important question for many hydraulic components, whether you're talking about reducing pressure control valves or talking about directional valves. Pilot operated and direct acting definition is consistent throughout those product lines. So it's going to be nice to understand what that difference is for the 25 or so percent of
okay.
the viewers.
Sounds good. So let's go ahead and start by taking a look at our Sun Hydraulics website. If you were to visit sunhydraulics.com, and we're going to take a look at our relief valve offerings today. We'll actually just take a look where it says cartridges, and as we hover over cartridges, we're just going to scroll down until we see the relief valves, and we'll click on that. And you'll notice that we offer 74 base models of relief valves. So is it safe to say that a large part of those are direct acting and a large part of those are pilot operated?
Sure, there's a significant number for both.
Okay, so that's kind of the first way that we segregate those valves. So what we're going to do is just kind of scroll down on the page until we find a way to filter out our direct acting valves, and we'll take a look at those first. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the direct acting option here, and that's now filtered out all of our direct acting valves.
So let's look at the circuit drawing, the symbol, the hydraulic symbol. You can see that it's a normally closed valve. We're looking at that first symbol there at the middle of the page. It's a normally closed valve. Pressure on port 1 works to open the valve against an adjustable spring. So that adjustable spring determines your setting of, you know, initial opening. Now, back pressure at port 2, 2 is normally the tank port on a relief valve. Back pressure adds to the setting of the cartridge at a ratio of 1:1. So it's a rather simple circuit drawing or symbol, and you guys have all seen it before, I'm sure. But let's talk about how this valve actually operates and what makes it direct acting.
Okay, for that, we're going to go ahead and take a look at an animation of how this valve works.
Okay, so we're showing you this cutaway to try and increase your understanding of direct acting. And what it is it's a piston directly connected to a spring, which is directly opposing pressure at port 1. So it's a single component. It's a single stage. Pressure times the area of the piston equals a force, and that force is created by the spring. So what does that mean? It means that it's a very fast valve. You have a quick response because the piston is directly sensing the pressure at port 1. There's no orifices or anything to slow this operation down. So direct acting valves, because of this design, have a very fast response.
Okay.
And there are some other features that we want to show you in the next slide.
Okay. So now we've seen kind of how the valve works. Let's go ahead and take a look at those features and why we would actually want to buy a direct acting valve.
Sure. So fastest response is big, because if you have many pressure spikes, this valve responds in 2 milliseconds. So it has the ability to clip pressure spikes. Also, because it's a piston poppet type seat, it has only 10 drops per minute. So it's suitable for load holding, which is important in some applications. And also, one of the other major factors of or benefits of a direct acting valve is that because there's no orificing, or it's not a very complex design, it's all directly, the piston directly opposes the spring, and that's it. It's rather viscosity tolerant and contamination tolerant. You can relieve a thick grease or a thin oil. Also, if small debris don't really affect this valve because you have a large opening and you don't see too much issues with contamination there.
Okay, so all of those features that you mentioned, fastest response, that positive seated seal, and the contamination tolerance, those all sound like exceptionally important features for me. I mean, why would I want to look at any other type of valve?
Well, these are great features, but maybe your system doesn't need the fastest response, and there are benefits to a pilot-operated design that may be more beneficial to your application.
Okay. Well, let's go ahead and do this then. We're going to go ahead and take a look at the website again, and we'll take a look at our pilot-operated valves and see if we can figure out the difference there. So we'll go ahead and filter out our pilot-operated relief valves, and we're just showing those models now. Can you tell us about them?
Sure. So the hydraulic symbol for the pilot-operated valve is very similar to the direct acting. Normally closed valve, pressure at port 1 opens the valve, back pressure at port 2 on the tank line adds to the setting. The only difference is that there's a pilot-operated symbol there on the back side of the valve to show you that it's pilot-operated. So if it shows that it's pilot-operated in the hydraulic symbol, that's an important aspect of the cartridge. So we want to share that design parameter with you.
Okay. Well, we've seen the symbol now, so just like before, I guess let's go ahead and take a look at how this valve actually operates.
So now it's not a single-stage valve like the direct acting. It's a two-stage valve. And what does that mean? It means that there's a small direct acting valve attached to the adjustment screw. So when you're turning your adjustment screw, you're making the setting of a small area, small capacity, direct acting relief valve in the back of this cartridge. And that valve controls a larger main stage, which is held closed by a lighter spring. So that gives you some other benefits. So you can see the two stages. You have a direct acting valve in the back and the blue main stage, the second stage, is your main piston.
Okay. So now we've seen how the pilot-operated valves work, and this
right.
is a two-stage device as opposed to the single stage, which would be the direct acting. Mm-hmm. So what are some of the features that would make us want a pilot-operated valve?
Well, I'll show you. Let's look at the next slide. Since the spring is lighter because you have a small area on the direct acting valve in the back of the pilot operated valve, it's a lighter spring. So you can adjust it under pressure very easily. A direct acting valve, the adjust screw sees the full pressure of port one, the relief side. So that can be a very high pressure and it could be hard to turn that adjustment screw. But the pilot operated is very easy to adjust. Maybe you start up a power unit for the first time and you're trying to fine-tune your relief setting. It's very easy to do with a pilot-operated valve. Another big thing is pressure regulation. Now, what does that mean? The direct-acting valve can regulate pressure as well, but the pilot-operated valve, because its main stage is held closed by that lighter spring, then as the valve opens, as more flow passes through the valve, there's less of a pressure setting increase. The spring does not encounter more load, and that gives you a flatter pressure rise curve versus flow. Okay. So let's say you set your valve at 3,000 psi for cracking pressure at full flow, maybe whether that's 25 or 50 or 100 GPM, that pressure is higher. Well, it's not much higher with the pilot-operated valve. It's less of a difference than direct acting. So if you're constantly flowing over your relief valve, if you're using the relief valve to regulate pressure consistently, a pilot-operated valve is likely the way to go. A direct-acting valve is better for maximum pressure limiting, pressure spike reduction, things like that that require the fast speed.
Okay. So just by way of quick recap then, we've talked about direct-acting, we've talked about pilot-operated. Maybe it's time for us to go ahead and throw another survey out there. What do you think?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so if you're next to your computers, go ahead and grab a mouse. We're going to throw another survey out on the screen there for you. We just want your opinion on this one real quick. And we chose to ask this question for a reason. It's always nice during these webinars to provide a little bit of market intelligence for you, just to kind of let you know a little bit more about our products and what people use the most of. So as we were considering our relief valves, one of the questions that comes up every now and again here and we thought we'd share with you is you know, what's the most popular relief valve at Sun? And so that's actually the next question that you're going to see on the screen. Multiple choice question. What do you think is the most popular relief valve at Sun? And so we're going to provide you with an answer for this in a moment, but just kind of wanted some feedback from you. What do you think is the most popular relief valve that we sell and that we manufacture here at Sun? And we've got a few options on the screen. If you're not completely familiar with our model codes, you might see RDDA, and that's just our standard direct acting relief valve. The RVCA is our standard ventable relief valve. The RPEC is our pilot operated, just a standard pilot operated relief valve. And the RPET is an anti-shock relief valve. So one of those is the most popular, but is popularity what it's all about, Dan?
No, absolutely not. When we say popularity, we don't mean how well the valves perform. What we mean is which valves are we shipping the most of? And what does that tell us? That tells us that a certain valve might have the most applications or be used by the most people, which is useful information when looking at Sun products for the first time and trying to understand where you need to begin.
Okay. So let's take a look at what you thought was the most popular valve at Sun. Oh, those are interesting results. What do you think? Did they get it right?
Well, RPEC is the winner, and so you guys got it right there, but it's the winner by such a small margin. It's less than 1%. So we really wanted to show you that direct acting and pilot operated both have a significant place in the market. There's not one clear winner. It depends on your application. So that's why we spent this time talking about pilot operated and direct acting for you.
Sure. Seems like from the data that we looked at, that the RDDA, the direct acting valve, was really close to the RPEC, the pilot operated. So, as Dan said, there's a great amount of room for both kinds of valves on the market. Let's do a little bit of a recap here.
Sure. So in the image, you can see some of the variations of the valves we have. Pilot operated and direct acting are available in very high flow rates. We go from a very small series zero valve for 7.5 gallons or so, all the way up to 200 GPM for a pilot operated RPKC. So we have flow capacities available. They share common cavities for the same capacity, so you can swap out between pilot-operated and direct-acting and anti-shock, some of the future cartridges we'll talk about later. We just recently implemented a phosphate ester fluid test stand at Sun, so you can actually get cartridges with EPDM seals for those flame-resistant hydraulic systems, and we test those here in phosphate ester fluid. Corrosion resistance. We have stainless steel cartridges and zinc nickel plated cartridges. And just to note, the stainless steel cartridges, everything exposed to the atmosphere is stainless or brass or some corrosion protected material. But the internal components are still your standard carbon steel, so they're not for use with water applications. So we offer a variety of cartridges, including proportional, TUV, PED certified cartridges, and all rated for 5,000 PSI. So we really, all those models give us many options to help us answer your application needs.
Okay. So we talked about the single stage direct acting, and then we also made mention that when you move over to the pilot operated, that two-stage architecture, it actually opens up the opportunity to have some different operational characteristics, mm-hmm. some different features that might benefit your system. Do we want to talk about some of those features and some valves that might really be of interest?
Sure. Well, what we're saying is that with pilot operated, there are more options other than just a two-port valve. So let's take a look. The first one here is a two-port valve. It's a poppet type pilot-operated relief. It's an RPES for the Series 1 frame size. And what that is it combines the low 10-drop-per-minute leakage of the RDDA with the easy adjustability and the nice modulation that you see in the RPEC. So that's a great option for you. Another good thing about that valve is that it does have a little bit faster response than 10 milliseconds. It's about 7 milliseconds. All very fast, but just something to note.
So it sounds like that valve is really kind of the best of both worlds.
Yeah, it takes the key features from both valves.
And puts them together. Mm-hmm. Okay.
The next one is a ventable valve. I'm sure many of you have seen this before, but it's basically the same as the RPEC, the pilot-operated relief valve, but it has a remote pilot port 3. And what that does is it determines an alternative setting. Either the adjustment screw or the pressure at port 3 becomes the setting of your cartridge, whichever one is lower. So let's say you want to constantly relieve at 1,000 PSI, but your failsafe, your maximum you could ever see is 2,000. You can adjust the adjustment screw to 2,000 and then maintain a constant pressure of 1,000 PSI on port 3, and that will kind of give you those two settings.
Okay.
Another good application, people use this as an unloading valve or something to dump pressure. And what you can do there is put a two-position, two-way solenoid valve on the outlet of port 3. The valve supplies pilot oil to port 3, and if you open up or if you block port 3, it will be at the setting of the adjustment screw. If you vent port 3, it fully dumps to unload a pump to some pressure under 100 PSI, as long as your flow isn't very high. So it could be used for that as well.
So we could remotely control the setting of the valve.
Mm-hmm.
Outstanding choice.
And then finally, we have a Sun-patented product in the anti-shock relief valve. And this is a two-port valve that doesn't remove pressure spikes with an extremely fast response like an RDDA does, but it removes pressure spikes by having a long response, a soft response. And what that is about 100 milliseconds to 500 milliseconds, or a half a second, of delayed pressure ramp.
Okay.
And if you have a very high cycle or a very short cycle time, this might not be the answer for you. The RDDA would. But if you have a large system that has shock loads, this valve can remove those dangerous high spikes that could cause some of your hydraulic components to fatigue over time.
So this valve would, in essence, eliminate those high-pressure spikes that we'd be concerned with.
Yes, it absorbs the pressure spikes caused by your system at a lower pressure to absorb that spike, and then it ramps up to your adjusted setting.
Okay.
There's virtually zero overshoot.
So another good choice.
And then finally, our proportional relief valves for higher flows are pilot-operated as well. You can see on your screen, we have a small direct-acting RBAP is the model code, electroproportional relief valve. And to make a higher flow proportional relief valve, you screw that valve into the T8A cavity in the back of a RP blank C 8 control. So the fifth letter is 8. And what that allows you to do is have up to 200 GPM of proportional pressure control. So you can use that for regulating pressure. You can use that to unload a pump by de-energizing the relief valve. We also offer an inverse proportional relief valve, RBAN, which normally with no power has a high setting. And then as you provide power to the coil, the setting comes down gradually. So the ultimate soft start valve could be a slow ramp on the proportional valve, or infinite settings very quickly can happen with a proportional valve.
Okay, so there's always a lot of interest in the electroproportional valves, and there's always a lot of interest in all of these valves. One of the things I wanted to say is that we've just given you a ton of information in a short period of time, and so it may be a little bit challenging to understand all of it. And that said, we want to just go ahead and direct you to the website real quick. And I want to make special note of this: if you're a customer with us today, or I have to tell you that a lot of the questions that you may encounter as you're considering choosing the right relief valve, a lot of those really can and should be handled by your local distributor. They're really going to be your first choice to answer any of the application questions you have, or to take a look at a circuit or a specific example. And so because your local distributor can help you to understand, what's the right proportional valve to use for your system, should I use an anti-shock or maybe a direct-acting valve, since those are the kinds of questions that are best suited to be discussed with your local distributor, I want to show you how to find some information about who that might be. So bear with me for just one second. What we're going to do is we're just going to visit the Sun Hydraulics website, and you'll notice on the top of the screen there's a contact tab. As you click on that contact tab, the next thing that'll open up is this option for you to click for quotations and purchases. And as you click that up, you click that, it'll open a screen that is going to show you all of Sun's authorized distributor network. So the easiest way to find the distributor in your area that can help you with all the hydraulic questions that you have in regard to Sun Hydraulics product would be to simply choose a map that is appropriate for your location. We're broadcasting to you today from Sarasota, Florida, so I'm just going to go ahead and choose the USA map. And as I choose the United States map, I'm just going to choose the location that makes sense for us. We're in Florida, so I'm going to click on Florida today. And you're going to note that Gulf Controls is the distributor that you would ask any of those questions to right here in Florida. But, find the distributor that is local to you. They would be your best bet to answer any of the questions that you have about any of Sun Hydraulics products, especially in regard to relief valves. And I also want to note this. We are certainly here and happy to help you out in any way. So what I've done is I've gone ahead and I've put the Sun info email address right up on the screen right now. I'm also going to invite you at this point, if you have any questions, you'd like us to clarify any of the information we've gone over today, feel free to go ahead and chat those questions in. Now is a great time for us to receive those questions and to begin to start answering some of those. We are going to be conscious of time and respectful of the fact that many of you are at work and can't stay on this webinar forever. So what we'll do is we'll answer a few of those questions. And then if you're thinking about it later on and you'd like to contact a distributor or Sun Hydraulics, please feel free to shoot us an email or give us a call. The way that you would contact us here at Sun would be to just send us an email at suninfo@sunhydraulics.com. Again, it's on the screen, suninfo@sunhydraulics.com. But if there's any questions, we'll go ahead and we'll be glad to start taking some of those questions. And I'll just read those off in the order that they come in and we'll begin to answer some of those.
Sounds great.
So it looks like the first question's already come in, and the question reads this way. What are the advantages and disadvantages of the fast-acting pilot-operated relief?
Well, I'm glad that somebody asked that question because we didn't touch on that valve in this presentation, but it's a good valve for certain reasons, and let's get into that. I think bringing the website up and going to the product page will help show everybody what this valve is exactly. And what it is, it's an RPEE. And it's a fast-acting valve because we removed the dampening orifice from the standard pilot-operated RPEC valve. And if you can see on the screen, fast-acting pilot-operated balanced piston relief valve. We take the dampening orifice out, right, which is right near the direct-acting relief valve, to increase the response time. There's no dampened pilot oil here. And what that does is it ends up giving you a fast response of 2 milliseconds, which is just as fast as a direct-acting relief, but the dampening orifice is gone, so it's actually somewhat unstable, gurgly. It's audible when the valve is in relief mode. Some of our customers have actually said that that's a benefit because they want to hear and know when the valve is in relief mode. But if you're regulating pressure constantly, if you need to regulate pressure with your relief valve, you're constantly flowing something over the relief, the RPEE is not a good choice because it's not smooth and quiet and stable like the RPEC is. The RPEC is very smooth and quiet and stable.
Okay. So a good advantage with speed and maybe a disadvantage in the audible nature of the valve.
Audible and stability.
Stability.
If you want stability, RPEC or RDDA.
Okay. Okay, we'll see if there's any other questions that are coming. It looks like some folks might be typing, so we'll give it just a moment. And as we're waiting for any other questions that come in, I'm just going to go ahead and remind you that we're leaving the email address front and center on the webinar page right now so that you can certainly send us an email as well. If you'd like us to respond, we can certainly respond via email. And again, I just want to go ahead and show you that from the Sun Hydraulics website, contacting your distributor is a very simple thing to do. Again, just simply select on the map of wherever you're trying to find a distributor, and it'll be fairly simple for you to go ahead and find a distributor for your territory. So just kind of wanted to put that out there and let you know that the distributor is still, you know, kind of the first line when it comes to answering any of your questions, but we're certainly happy to help you in your search for the right relief valve for your particular application. Mm-hmm. So drop us a line at suninfo@sunhydraulics.com. Doesn't look like we're getting too many more questions in here. It looks like somebody might be typing, so we'll give them just one more moment and see if we can respond to that question in kind. And if not, then we'll go ahead and end the webinar as soon as we know whether we can answer this question.
Sure.
Okay, here we go. The question just came in. What does balanced piston indicate?
Well, balanced piston is used to describe the pilot-operated relief valve because it's not a differential area valve like the direct-acting valve. It's balanced piston, meaning that it has those pilot-operated characteristics. Balanced piston also differentiates the standard spool-type RPEC from the balanced poppet valve that we talked about was the two-port valve with a poppet that has less leakage. So balanced piston and a balanced poppet, it means it's a pilot-operated balanced piston/poppet design, but it's the piston, a little bit more leakage than the poppet, which is 10 drops per minute. So balanced piston.
So piston is really the key word there. It's just a little bit different design using a piston instead of a poppet.
All of the pilot-operated valves have balanced pistons or poppets. So balance isn't the key there. The key is piston.
Okay, very good.
A little more leakage.
All right. Doesn't look like we're getting any other questions in at the moment, and that's completely fine. That means we did our job well, and everyone is satisfied. Just in case you do come up with a question over the next few hours or over the next day even, if you'd like to drop us a line, feel free to go ahead and send an email to suninfo@sunhydraulics.com. Again, we're certainly happy to help you in any way that we can. Again, that's suninfo@sunhydraulics.com. And I think right now the appropriate thing to do is to say thank you very much for joining us today. We appreciate your time. We had a great time bringing this information to you. Again, give us a call or send us an email if you need anything else from us. And if not, we'll go ahead and end the webinar today.
Yeah, thank you, everybody. Have a great holiday.
Thank you.